In the previous presentation, I have already discussed about the C string library basics, and we have also discussed about the strcpy function, also known as string copy function. Now in this presentation, we will consider one more important function which is available in this library called strlen function, also known as string length function. So let's get started. The prototype of this strlen function or string length function is as follows. Size t with strlen within these round brackets const char str. Now you might ask me this question that what is this size t over here? Here size t is simply representing an unsigned integer type of at least 16 bits. You actually don't have to bother about this size t at all. Think of it as this strlen function will return an integer value, that is the length of the string. Okay? This size t is basically representing an unsigned integer type of at least 16 bits. Now it depends upon your computer that it would be 16 bits or more than 16 bits. strlen function is used to determine the length of the given string. When we provide a string to strlen function, it will return the length of the string. Actually, we are not passing the whole string to it, we are passing the pointer to the first character of that string, right? But it will return the length of that particular string. To the strlen function, we should pass the pointer to the first character, as I've already discussed this, of the string whose length we want to determine. And as a result, it returns the length of the string, right? There is one point we should note down that it doesn't count null character at all. If we have a string, let's say hello, then the strlen function, that is string length function, will return 5 as the output and not 6 because it will not count the null character which is there at the end of the string. Okay? Now let's consider one example here. Here we can see we have a main function, and within this main function, we have a pointer to a character. And we are simply passing a string literal to it, that is hello world. And we want to determine the length of this string, so we are passing the string to this strlen. Actually, we are passing the pointer to the first character to it, and it will return the length of this whole string. Output of this program is 11. Therefore, the length of this string is 11. And please note down that this strlen function will never count the backslash 0 or null character. That's why the output comes out to be 11 and not 12. Okay? Now let me change this code a little bit. We have changed this to these square brackets. The rest of the code is exactly the same. Now the output in this case is also 11. There is no change. Okay? But what if I add 100 here? You might think the output will be 100. Because the size of this array is 100, but again it will return 11. Why is that so? Because it calculates the length of the string and not the length of the array. This strlen function always calculates the length of the string and it will never calculate the length of the array. We are simply passing the string of length 11 and not of length 100. Even though the character array can accommodate up to 100 characters, but still it will calculate the length of the string and not the length of the whole array. Okay friends, this is it for now. Thank you for watching this presentation.